call you want, goes to the outside of the field. Gates open, racing, great line away as well, so likeable showing early. Dash is going to roll to the top though, and goes clear soon after, settling into stride, coming across Prince I Think, and also driving forward is Talk All You Want to be prominent. On the inside, She's Puzzling occupies fourth spot soon after the start, followed then by Don't Show Me Up, drifting back into the field outside of Awesome Rival. A length and a half behind those then is You Can Tell Me, as they work off the back straight. Going up now, just in front of it is Master Safari, followed back in the field by the Panzer, and tailed out a distant last is Master Tradesman. They start to string out here as they work past the 700. So Likeable and Johnston Porter had ramped the pace up, nearing the 600. So Likeable led by two, running second is Prince I Think. A length and a half away, She's Puzzling, saved up down on the inside by Parnham, followed then by Talk All You Want, which is fourth coming towards the home turn. Right around the outside is Master Safari. Safari going up in front of the baldy face, Don't Show Me Up. Awesome Rival cut the corner, making ground. So Likeable at the cutaway. Down to the 250 clear, but here She's Puzzling and Awesome Rival. The two fancies are starting to put their runs in as Awesome Rival ranges up to She's Puzzling. They go to the 100 now. Awesome Rival on the outside. She's Puzzling tries to rally. Awesome Rival, though, has the momentum. Awesome Rival proved too good. Awesome Rival scored from She's Puzzling. Now the Panzers come from well back, might have grabbed third just in front of Prince I Think, and also So Likeable. A gap then, You Can Tell Me, followed home by Master Safari, Master Tradesman, and tailed off behind those Talk All You Want and Don't Show Me Up. Awesome Rival, Chris Parnham, has taken out race two for the day. It's 8 Awesome Rival over 9 She's Puzzling. And the Panzer are certainly the one hurtling down the outside after being back there in the field, making up many, many lengths late. Awesome Rival, though, after getting back itself, Chris Parnham was able to cut the corner, save valuable ground, and set out after She's Puzzling, who tracked up beautifully in behind the pacemaker, So Likeable most of the way. But Awesome Rival, they have found this in the market, certainly some of the earlier markets, and has proven too good. By Awesome Rock from Bayella, trained by Michael Lane and ridden by Chris Parnham. For Pete Capararo, Mrs. R. White, E. and Mrs. J. Fox, G.D. Grover, Johnny Scray, John Pusey, and Ms. C. Gleason, Eddie McKeljic, B. Ryan, Ms. L. Norrish, Mrs. K. L. Norrish, and Ms. C. Caldwell, G. Thomas, P. Morgan, B. Christie, Mrs. J. Crane, B. Edwards, and J. Witten, and opens up her account this afternoon at career start number 7, defeating She's Puzzling. Looked as though she was given every chance there from that inside gate by Brad Parnham for the Christina Clark stable. And my admiration, Champs-Élysées mare for Hunter Racing. And 5 Panzer did grab third. And it's a Rommel from Gronkett Gelding, trained by Fred Kersley and ridden by Troy Turner. Fourth home, 11 Prince, I Think, 8, 9, 5, 11. And margins are a length by 3.5 in 124.02, 36.31 that last 600 there. So Awesome Rival at just her third run in the preparation salutes, and she does the job very well. Chrissy Parnham there topples Brad in race number 2. In the third, the Crown Perth Plate over the 1400. 4 Truvinsky, the late one of 5 Cruzy Roy on Vet's Advice, they're out, and Brad Parnham's now on to 6 Lord Randolph. Jade McNaught will steer 7 Rock on Molly. The two riding changes there on top of the two scratchings in the third here on the card. As we now join Brittany Taylor in the yard, Putter's certainly astute enough there, finding Awesome Rival at a third run in the campaign.
Oh, that's right. They got it right, didn't they, the punters? They identified the first two that have finished first and second there as the main chances, and that's exactly what they were, with Awesome Rival going the better. Michael Lane joins me now. And Michael, she's been a handy little acquisition for your stable. What were your first impressions when she first arrived in your yard?
Yeah, well, she spelled it. Used to spell it my place. That's how it's come about. And then the owner decided to sell a few shares in her, and so I thought, oh, well, look, she's done what she's done as a two-year-old, so I went and put a few of my owners in the horse, and it didn't all go to plan. The first prep, she took a little chip off a joint, and so she's been a work in progress, but, yeah, obviously she's shown a bit, and to be able to buy into a horse ready to go was always a plus, you know, so we've got to thank Wes White for that.
with that joint? Do you just have to manage her, or, you know, are things going well at the moment?
Yeah, things are going pretty good with it. So I think she's very mature anyway. So hopefully with time that she actually gets better as time goes on. That's what she gives my impressions anyway.
How did you view today's performance up to 1,400 metres?
Yeah, look, I've been a little bit disappointed the first couple of runs back, to be honest, but obviously Chris thought she'd got a bit looking for the 14, so, yeah, I was really happy the way she hit the line.
Is this her mark, or you want to stretch out even further?
Oh, I think she'll definitely get up to a mile, but I'll talk to Chris about that, and we'll see where we head next start.
Get in this photo.
All right, thanks, Brittany.
There is Michael Lane, and jumping in the photo by Western Race Picks just in the nick of time there, and then Scott will get a word with Chris, and... after the victory there of Awesome Rival.
Nice bit of efficiency there, getting the photo out the way. Now, Chris, Awesome Rival, what have you made of her two runs in this preparation?
They've been okay. Probably been a little bit disappointing, thinking she was going to win, but I think the first up run, we were too close outside the leader, and then she was just okay late the other day. I thought she might be looking for a bit more distance, and it worked for her today.
Is she looking for further again?
I wouldn't put it beyond her, yeah. She was pretty strong through the line then, so, yeah, I think she'll get out to a mile.
An expectation for final series in the next?
Yeah, it's it went good the other day, but probably faces a little bit of a stronger field. I think Colin Webster's horse, you know, was good the other day, so it'll be hard to beat, but expecting a forward showing for my bloke.
Best of luck.
Thanks.
Chris Parnham and Michael Lane, they combine with Awesome Rival, taking out the Amelia Park Maiden.